for coming, Dr. Engel.
His Highness Prince Karl Franz is in an interview with His Majesty. I have requested an honor of an audience with the Prince when he is finished. He will join us here.
I wish to speak with you alone first, Dr. Engel, as I have some news of importance to communicate to you. Please, be seated.
Thank you, Count von Mark.
For the past 8 years, you have conducted the education of His Highness, the heir apparent to the throne of Carlsberg. Your labors had a most gratifying result yesterday when His Highness passed before the council with honors his entrance examination for the University of Heidelberg.
It was a good examination, wasn't it?
I have been commissioned to communicate to you that as a reward, His Majesty is graciously pleased to nominate you a member of the Privy Council.
A Privy Councillor? Impossible!
It is not impossible, it is a fact!
My congratulations!
You have before you a year of grave responsibility.
In what way?
In accompanying His Highness to the University of Heidelberg, it will be your solemn duty as a member of the Privy Council to watch over him in his daily life and to keep us well informed about how he conducts himself in his new environment. He must be guarded from the dangers of university life.
Spy on Karl Franz, never.
It is for the honor of the kingdom, as well as the prince's own protection. Furthermore, you will preserve in every possible way the dignity and etiquette of the court routine with which the prince has been surrounded.
But his most serene highness, Prince Karl Franz.
I've just received your message. Has your excellency been waiting long?
It is my duty to wait upon you, Highness. Will your Highness permit me to offer my congratulations on the brilliant results of your examination?
Oh, thank you.
It will be the task of Counselor Engel here.
Counselor?
It will be the task of Counselor Engel here to be a diligent guide to your Highness in your new life. At the end of the university year, His Majesty wishes to announce the public betrothal of your Highness and the Princess Margaret, your cousin. A beautiful and most worthy choice for your Highness.
So I've been told. I've not seen her.
May I have the honor of accompanying your Highness to the station tomorrow?
Oh yes, thank you, if you will be so good.
My humble duty, Highness.
Maybe Counselor.
Don't, it's terrible. They'll be giving me the cross of Saxony next.
What's the matter?
It's a bribe, boy, that's all. I'm to go with you to Heidelberg to preserve court etiquette and to keep you from light and air and sunshine.
Nonsense.
They've crushed you in this gloomy fortress all your life, and now, when you have a chance of life and happiness, they order me to play the jailer and to keep you away from it all. But I won't. I resign. Go on your way without me, Karl Franz. Go and God bless you.
Why, Doctor, have you forgotten all the plans we made ever since I was a little chap to go away together someday to Heidelberg? How you told me of the river nectar and of the students' work, how they sing in the evening.
So quaint, no one to say the much less. Yes, Excellency.
Yes, sir. Ruder, at your senses.
At your service.
Ruder, please keep a distance of at least 5 feet when in our presence. Do I smell cabbage?
I should say red cabbage, Excellency.
Outrageous. Oh, it's very tasty, Your Highness. With red herring. Oh, it's the best thing for your appetite before a fine dish of sausage.
Sausage?
Hubert!
Yes, Excellency.
I feel ill. Take the sausage and the curse away. Wait, explain who you are.
His Excellency wishes me to tell you that he's not His Serene Highness, Prince Carl Franz of Carter.
That's it, Prince. Then, who is it?
Mr. Lux.
Lux? Well, who is he?
The Honorable Johann Henry Peter Lux.
Well,
he's the Prince's personal valet.
Valet?
The Prince's personal attendant. A position of enormous influence. I hold the prince in the hollow of my hand. If I am fully impressed with your accommodations, we stay. If I am dissatisfied, we go.
Oh, don't say that, Mr. Lutz. You shall have everything just as you wish it. Gretchen, go and get some wine. Our best.
Thank you. Thank you. the beginning of our most glorious term. Who is to be honored for the month of May? Who but Kathy? Stand still, Kathy. The Saxon Corps entrusts its silken band to you as the only woman in Heidelberg to be present this evening at our solemn festival. With honor, Kathy!
With honor!
Say.
Go on, don't wait all day.
was charming. What is your name, young lady?
Happy, sir.
If your highness will permit me to point you. Later, later. Where is the landlord?
Here, sir. Joseph Rudin at your service. And this is my niece, Kathy. And that is Gretchen. Oh, if his serene highness would have the graciousness to take possession of his home.
Very well, I go. Your highness, it is my sacred duty to point out that this is an impossible residence for your highness.
What's this?
Explain. The rooms are old. The furniture is shabby. The stairs are an invitation to suicide. The plumbing?
Oh, and there is the low drinking establishment on the first floor.
I'm delighted to hear it. You may bring me a bottle of wine, my child.
Oh, yes, sir, Redway.
Will your highness be pleased to order his luggage brought down right away and I shall secure a suite at the hotel for the present?
What do you think?
Why doesn't your highness inspect the place and decide for himself?
Very well, I go.
Your highness, it is worth your life to go in there!
Beer is the official drink
of the Saxon Corps. Will you join our noble band? Have you made your choice?
I don't understand.
You can only go a day in Heidelberg without the cap and bands of the Corps. Join the noble band of Saxons.
I don't think I can.
Listen, dear old man. You must join our Corps. It isn't good for one to live alone.
Yes, but I just got here today.
I must go. That's our sacred toast. Will you join the Saxons?
I'll think it over. Thank you.
Don't be too long about it. What is that? A nightingale?
Thank you.
at every inn along the way.
We ran into a country wedding!
And they all kissed the bride!
You should have come with us, Kathy.
On your carousing parties, not me.
But you must come along now, or we'll keep it up all night. We'll go up to the river.
Oh, I'm just really drunk.
Oh, an absent Swedish punch.
No, not Swedish punch.
Turkish punch.
I want to put it together, Kathy. We're going to the woods just as we did last Sunday.
I insist the punch was Turkish.
Let's compromise on some cognac now.
Cognac? Nonsense. Champagne. It is the nicest thing in the world for breakfast.
Champagne!
Thank you.
the prince a little inconvenient.
Silence. The prince lives an ascetic life at Heidelberg. Isn't that so, Lutz?
Oh, dear, yes. He always spends his mornings in meditation.
That'll do, Lutz. Don't strain your imagination.
What is an ascetic, Tarnitz? Some type of hermit?
I should say, princess, an object of pity.
Modest, don't be frivolous.
Why not, mother? I must amuse myself if he's going to keep me waiting indefinitely.
Lutz, would you please inform the prince that politeness is the punctuality is the politeness of kings.
Yes, but he is yet a prince, so perhaps you and the princess may be a little patient. How's the entry? Prince is coming!
Oh my goodness! I must look fright! And a first impression is so important!
You couldn't look anything other than divine.
Tarnitz, your opinion is completely unnecessary.
His Serene Highness, Prince Karl Franz of Karlsberg!
My dear Prince.
Duchess.
You must forgive this unheralded visit. But my affection for you is such that I could not pass through your college town without assuring myself of your well-being.
I thank you, and I trust that you're here for an interesting visit, Duchess.
May I present my daughter, Princess Margaret Alexis Elizabeth Eugenia Marie. Your fiancée. She is fresh from the convent, knowing nothing of the world.
That will come later.
It is an honor, Princess.
It is indeed a pleasure, cousin.
Oh, my deepest respect, dear cousin.
Oh, dear God.
I trust I find you in good health, cousin.
Thank you, dear cousin.
What a delightful little chat.
Oh, God.
I thought this was the perfect opportunity for you and Margaret to meet informally. It will relieve the tension of the betrothal ceremonies in Karlsberg.
Betrothal ceremonies?
Why, yes. A courier came from your grandfather, the king, last night and instructed us to set off immediately.
Strange. I had not heard. Your Highness, fresh horses have been harnessed, and we may proceed at your pleasure.
Thank you. Well, as much as I would love to prolong this visit, your grandmother, so punctual, he will expect us at the hour. Margaret!
Yes, Mama?
Make your review.
Goodbye, cousin. I shall see you again soon.
It will be an honor, Princess.
I trust that it will be a pleasure, also.
I trust that it will be a pleasure as well.
What's the matter?
The Prime Minister is here.
What? Impossible.
Oh, no, it's possible. Count von Marc is here and he is coming upstairs.
I won't see him. Tell him I'm gone.
He's here. Highness.
Your Highness, you must pardon this sudden visit. I come from Carlsberg. I've traveled all night. I'm the bearer of serious news.
My grandfather, the king.
No, it is not the end, Your Highness, but my instructions are to ask you to return with me at once.
No. I cannot.
Your Highness, if the king is seriously ill, he asks for you continually.
My poor grandfather. I'm sorry. I cannot come.
Prince, it is your duty. His Majesty is most anxious to set his affairs in order before he passes on. He has summoned the Princess Margaret so that the betrothal ceremony can take place before his very eyes. Your Highness must come.
Do you know what you ask of me? Once I'm there, you'll tie me hand and foot, just as I was bound for 20 years. But since I've been here, my eyes have been opened. Heidelberg has taught me that I am a man.
Your Highness is called as next heir in line to prepare for your inheritance. It is your duty.
And I refuse.
Do you realize the consequences?
Only too well. I will be a free man.
Alfred! Alfred! Let us hold it. The king is ill. He is calling for you. You must go back, Alfred.
Never. They promised me a 4-year, 12 months. Now, after 4 has passed, they want me to go back to prison.
But you'll come back to Heidelberg, Alfred. It is understood that if the prince wishes, he can return to Heidelberg and complete his university year.
If the prince wishes, most assuredly.
The path of duty is often a lonely one, but it lies straight before you now, Count Franz. Your grandfather is ill. Your place is at his side.
Very well. I will go.
We must start at once. I will have everything in readiness. I wait for your highness below.
Courage!
Thank you. to the ends of the earth.
That would be a very dull place.
It would be paradise with you.
Paradise lost, my friend. You have trained to be a soldier, to wear a uniform and to waltz like an angel, whereas I have put an arduous preparation for the very serious business of being a queen.
How can you give your heart to this man who does not love you, whose heart and soul are with another woman?
What do you mean?
It is well known that while the prince was a student in Heidelberg, he had a low intrigue with a peasant girl.
I don't believe it!
Her name is Kathy. She was the waitress at the Inn of the Three Golden Apples.
So that's the reason?
Yes. That is the reason for all of his delays, of his coldness, his indifference.
Stop! Harnett! You forget that you were speaking of my future husband. These are all just silly rumors, started by my enemies to prevent my marriage. How disappointed they would be.
You have permitted my devotion, encouraged it.
Court mourning is so dull. I must pass the time.
Princess, you are very cruel.
Women are often cruel when they are unhappy. Oh yes, I owe you the truth. That's why I turned to you, Torrance. I'm flirting with you. In the hopes that it might awaken interest.
The council has decided.
June 1st is the date set for the wedding.
The royal honeymoon shall take place at the royal villa Montplaisir on Lake Cuomo.
Does the council guarantee a full moon and a royal nightingale especially appointed for the occasion?
His Majesty is pleased to jest.
Forgive me. Tell the council I have approved the program.
By all means, Your Majesty.
Thank you.
wife.
Luke, Blake, List, oh,
going on the surface.
Immediately. And into the hotel business.
With the lady who is about to become my wife.
That's leaving me. It's impossible. Who will bring me my breakfast? Who will maintain this facade?
Tell him we will have a fully equipped barber shop and excellent quarters for valets.
Yes, I need to.
Oh, that's...
Pudding bag.
Songs from
Majesty.
My time is up. I must ask you to leave me, gentlemen. But as you go, please sing one of our student songs. I will carry that memory with me. Goodbye.
Thank you.